to look at type 2 exponential equations, and these are the ones where we cannot create the same base. So for example, 2 to the x is equal to 5. How do I solve that? Because I cannot write 5 to have a base that matches 2. This is where you're going to use properties of logarithms. You're going to pull logs in. Now, some people, what they do is they use the common log, L-O-G, for certain equations, and they use the natural log, ln, for others. I just use ln for all of them because you get the same answer at the end of the day. And then when you have base e, having the natural log makes it easier. So I'm just going to ln both sides, natural log both sides, right? That's a log of base e, don't forget. So I'm going to natural log both sides. So I have ln of 5 on the right, and this is just the number that I could plug into the calculator. And if I plug it into the calculator, it is approximately 1.609, but I'm going to keep it in exact form. Now, the reason that the natural log or logging both sides is awesome is because your exponent contains your variable, and you need to get it down. And the only way to get it down, if I cannot create the same base, is to use the properties of logs, which there is one that states that I could bring the x to the coefficient of this term and make it x times ln of 2. Now, why does that help? Because now it's x times just a number. Ln of 2 is a number. Ln of 2 is approximately 0.693. I'm going to keep it in exact form. But how do I isolate x? All I have to do is divide both sides by this number, right? And then the x is isolated. X is equal to ln of 5 divided by ln of 2. And this is my exact solution. Let me plug that into my calculator. If I want to find the approximate value of x, plug it into my calculator, I get about 2.322 if I round to the nearest 1/10,000. Okay, so again, no limitations on what I can plug in for x in the exponent. This is the exact solution. This is my approximate, okay? So you need to know both, just in case. I always ask my students for both. So this is the exact solution, this is the number, and this is approximately what the solution is when I plug this into my calculator. Now these type 2 equations can get funky. Here's another one that has base e. So, I mean, it's the same idea though. I have an exponential equation because I recognize that the variable is in the exponent. It's not type 1 because of the fact that I cannot create the same base. I have no idea how to write 793 to have a base of e. So I'm going to natural log both sides. Now this is why I always like to use the natural log. I'm going to write this on the right-hand side first. Natural log of 793, this is just a number. Here's why I like to use the natural log, because when the base is e, I have a property of logarithms that says that these will cancel each other out, and it'll just bring that exponent down. That's one of the basic properties of logs that we talked about, you know, way back in the basics of properties of logs. So ln is a log of base e, of e to the 1 minus 5x. They cancel each other out because they have the same base, and then that exponent comes down and simplifies. And then, you know, all I have to do is isolate x. Subtract 1 from both sides. Negative 5x is equal to ln of 793 minus 1. Be careful that that minus 1 does not go into this number. I'm not subtracting 1 from 793. 793 is attached to the natural log, and that 1 is outside of it. Do not confuse the two. Isolate my x, divide both sides by negative 5. So this is what my solution will look like in exact form. X is equal to ln of 793, that value, minus 1, divided by negative 5. And you're going to see typically that, I mean, this is a solution. We don't leave a negative in the bottom. So I'm either going to bring it to the numerator or put it in front. But if I bring it into the numerator, it changes the signs of my numerator. This becomes positive and this becomes negative. And this is the way we would technically represent the exact solution, more so than this. 1 minus ln of 793 divided by 5. And if I want, let me plug that into my calculator. Oops. 1 minus ln of 793 divided by 5 is approximately negative 1.135. And you can always take this number, plug it in here, and see if these are approximately the same. You can always check your solution. It's very easy to do that. Here's another example. Now, this one's a little bit uglier, only because, well, you'll see what happens. Again, I want you to be able to recognize the fact that it's a type 2 exponential equation. First of all, it's exponential because my variable's in the exponent. It's type 2 because I have a 5 base and a 3 base, and there's no way that I can create the same base between those two. So I'm going to natural log both sides and use the properties of logs to get those exponents down. So now this exponent, this 2x minus 3, comes in the front of ln of 5. And this x minus 1 comes in the front of ln of 3. Now I want you to notice that I put this in parentheses, because when I take a expression that has multiple terms and I multiply it by a number, that number distributes to every term in the expression. So this is where these get funky, okay? When that exponent is an expression of multiple terms, it gets distributed with this, or this gets distributed into it. So I put parentheses always to remember that. So that means that now I have 2x times ln of 5. I'm going to write it as 2x times ln of 5. Minus 3 times ln of 5. Minus 3 ln of 5. Is equal to, distribute this, x times ln of 3 minus 1 times ln of 3. Okay? Don't let the form scare you. This is a number. This is a number. This is a number, and this is a number. Anytime you have an equation to solve and you have x's on different sides, you always bring your x's to one side and you always bring your constant terms to another. I'm going to get all my x terms to the left and all my constant terms to the right. So this is an x term because it has an x, so I'm going to subtract it from both sides, because when I take anything and subtract itself, you know, it goes to zero. So I'm going to actually show my work. I'm not going to skip any steps. So I have 2x times ln of 5 minus x ln of 3. Minus 3 ln of 5 is equal to now negative ln of 3 on the right. Now, I have two variable terms here and one constant term. This is a constant number, so I need to pull this over and bring it to the right. So I'm going to add it to both sides, right? Plus 3 ln of 5. So now I have on the left 2x times ln of 5 minus x times ln of 3. This went away. And on the right, I have 3 ln of 5. Minus ln of 3. Okay, so at least I have all my variable terms on the left and all my constant terms on the right. Every term on the left has an x, every term on the right does not. The reason that you want to do that is, now I can actually factor out that x. Each term here has an x, so I could take it out. When I do that, this is what I'm left with, right? I'm left with this 2 ln of 5 and this ln of 3. And then I'm gonna leave this the way that it is. And why does that help me? Well, now I have x times a number. All this is just a number. It's an ugly number. It's a number in exact form. It's an ugly number, but I could plug it into the calculator and actually get a numerical value. It's a decimal. So I can cancel that from both sides and isolate my x. And then on the right, I have 3 ln of 5 minus ln of 3 divided by 2 ln of 5 minus ln of 3. And now all of this on the right-hand side is just a number. So now I have my value of x. Now if I want to determine, I'm going to plug this into my calculator. If I want to determine the approximate value of x, I'm going to plug that into my calculator. Be very careful with your parentheses. And then 2 ln of 5 minus ln of 3. I get approximately 1.759. Okay. I like my students, again, to know both versions. You may see something like this, and let me just show you. When I have a coefficient in front of, you know, a natural log, I can make it an exponent. That'll become a 5 to the third, which is 125 minus ln of 3 over, this is, you know, ln of 5 squared, so ln of 25 minus ln of 3. And you might see them actually use the properties of logs to simplify this even further. This is a preference. When I'm subtracting two natural logs, I can convert that to division, ln of 125 over 3, and then all over ln of 25 over 3. These are separate terms. And then you could leave it like that also. It's just preference. It depends. All these represent the same actual value at the end of the day.